We're back with some Mind Games, which is a fabulous show here on Rogers TV. It's been running for quite a while now, and if you hadn't had a chance to check it out, you are missing out. And we have the star of that show, James White, joins us. James, welcome to the show. Great to have you
Hi,
here.
James.
James, for those viewers that haven't seen the show yet, explain, what's the concept behind Mind Games?
So basically what we did is we took psychological and scientific principles and used them to give the illusion that I can read minds. So it's basically like appearing psychic without actually being psychic.
Right. You call this mentalism, right?
It's mentalism. I call it mostly mind reading because it sounds more cool.
Right.
Because you know mentalism, you kind of think of like an older person. So I'm kind of trying to make it more modern, I guess.
So how were you introduced to this
thing? So I started, I took different principles. So when I was young, I started doing magic when I was 7.
Okay.
And so I took elements from magic. I studied, I don't believe in psychics, but I know how they do it. Like, they use concepts like cold reading and stuff.
Okay.
So I took elements from that. So I basically took all these elements and then give the illusion that I can go, boom, I can read your mind.
Okay, so can you give us an example right now?
Like, of an effect, or do you want to?
Sure.
You want me to do something?
Yeah, sure. Do something. Yeah, absolutely.
I'll attempt something.
Okay.
The pressure. No.
I'm on TV.
Okay. I decided to use cards because cards are... I want to use them for 52 different items, not because, like, a magic trick.
Okay. All right.
Okay.
So, I'm just going to take out the Joker.
This looks like a new pack, too.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's pretty worn out, actually.
All right. So, is this something that you commonly do, using cards?
I try to use cards once in my whole set.
Okay.
So, I don't, on the TV show, we didn't use cards at all.
All right.
Because the problem with cards is they're too associated with magic.
Right.
And I'm trying to get away from that.
You want to disassociate yourself from that because you're not a magician.
It's kind of a magic trick. It might not work, but well, hopefully it works.
It might not work. What kind of setup is that, Jay?
It's because it's up to you guys. A lot of stuff I do is all up to you.
Okay.
So like I have a deck.
Yeah.
They're all different or whatever. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to cut the cards like that. Every time I cut it, there's a different card on top.
Right.
So Lois, what I want you to do is there's different every time. So I'm going to get you to cut the cards once. Okay, I'm now going to look away. I want you to do it again.
Okay.
Do you want to do it again? Or are you happy?
Okay.
She did it one more time.
Cheater. No. Okay, so I now want you to take the top card and look at it.
Can I show people at home?
No.
Okay.
Okay.
But show Derek.
All right. Got it.
Did the camera catch that?
Derek, take the card.
Okay.
And put it somewhere in the middle of the deck, somewhere in the middle.
All right. Okay. Done.
Okay.
Your card is the 17th card in the deck.
17th card in the...
Actually, you hold on to it. Okay, I guess it's kind of risky for TV. I'm going to ask you to turn it over one at a time on the table.
One.
Stop
one.
At 16, though.
Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, eleven, twelve, thirteen, fourteen, fifteen.
Okay, stop. So what do you think the chances of this actually working are?
50-50.
No, I think they're less than that.
So when you think about it, I have to somehow figure out the card and somehow know what the card is in the deck, even though I was looking away the whole time.
Right.
This is impossible to
King of Spades? Was that your card?
That was our
Turn
card.
Turn your card over. Show the camera.
What?
Oh my God!
So that's what I mean. So
that's the kind of reaction you get throughout the entire show. Actually, you know what? We have a clip of the show. Let's roll a clip of the show, and we'll come back because Lois had a cool experience on the show as well.
She did really well.
And we'll talk about that in just a minute. Roll the clip.
Who wants to try this? You do, right?
Sure.
I want you to think of the name of someone who is no longer with us, like someone who has passed on.
So we wrote our names down, and I was first, and then after everybody wrote their living names down, we put them in the envelopes, and he wasn't allowed to look or touch them. Somebody else took them and shuffled them up and confirmed we couldn't see, so he couldn't, you know, read it. And we went through each envelope. He's like, this one's living, this one's living. The last one he handed to me, and then he just kind of was like, hey, just think of the name repetitively. And he just came over, just looked into my eyes, and 30 seconds later.
Was this person a male or a female?
Male.
Gerald Green. Gerald Green. Was that the name?
Yeah.
It was Gerald Green?
Yeah. It was freaky. Like, I don't know how you can get a name that you've never heard of or know who they are or anything just by looking at someone's eyes for 30 seconds. And it was freaky. And I don't know if you could see it, but my hands were like this because it's unsettling. It's like it's like peering into someone's soul. It's like, it's unsettling. I'm like, he's just going to know everything about me.
Get out of my brain. I forgot to wear my helmet. I was going to make an aluminum foil helmet today.
You know, like those great clip. Like, how do you... I mean, obviously, you can't explain it, or people wouldn't be...
The thing is, if you actually watch the show, sometimes I do explain it. Like, the fact that I did it on Lois, I actually explained it in the show with the photo. I don't know if...
Let's talk about that. First of all, Lois, let me interview you for a moment. So what was that experience like, being on James's show?
Just as freaky as it was right now, because James gave me an envelope that he had signed and I had signed.
Yeah.
And basically, I had to hold on to it for about a week or so and look at this. He also gave me a picture.
Okay.
So I had to look at this picture all week, whenever I felt like it. And it ended up that what was in the envelope was actually a death certificate for the person who was in the photo.
And I asked her to name a random time, and she said 12:15, and that was the time of her death on the death certificate.
And you had never seen the death certificate before in your life?
She was holding it for a week, like I didn't touch anything.
Unbelievable.
And that was the time in the photo as well.
And then in the photo, there was a clock tower in the back.
Right.
And it was at 12:15.
That just so happened to be when I looked at the photo. How does that even work?
Magic of the mind. Sorry. Psychic powers.
The psychic powers of James. When does the show air here on Rogers TV?
Fridays at 10 o'clock and Saturdays at 10:30.
Unbelievable. James, congratulations on the show as well. We're so proud to have you part of the Rogers family.
Yeah.
You did a fantastic job.
Definitely worth tuning in.
Absolutely.
Wear your helmets.
That's right. It's Mind Games with James White right here on Rogers TV. Don't go away. More daytime coming up after this.